time at St. John's. It's really good to have you here, particularly for such a large service before we can't have any public worship for the next month. It's particularly good to have with us the Invicta Sinfonia and those who are joining our choir this evening. Thank you to you, our regular singers, our wardens for making this evening possible, and particularly to Jack, our director of music, who's had such an ambitious evening in store for us so that we can remember and pray for those whom we have loved but see no longer. I'm thanking him now and the rest of our players and singers this evening, because there won't be a chance to thank them at the end, because this is Mass. But I'm sure you'd all share with me in wanting to thank them for all of their wonderful efforts and music this evening. I've heard them earlier and they were really brilliant. And a very warm welcome as well to those of you who are here to mourn loved ones, particularly those whose funerals I have taken for you this year, or for anyone else who's mourning anyone whom they have lost this year. And I know that, as with the rest of our community, we're all here for you, we continue to be here for you, and even more so during the lockdown, so please get in touch if any of us can do anything for you at all, whether in prayer or conversation, or coming to help you with more practical needs. And so this evening, as we come to pray for those whom we have lost, to worship God, to take comfort and solace in the sacrament, we keep a moment of quiet before our musicians lead us in prayer.
Hold on.
his treasure in earthen vessels, to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. As we acknowledge our human frailty, we call to mind our sins of word, deed, and omission, and confess them before God our Father. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past and lead us out from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for the peace and well-being of the whole Church. Everlasting God, our Maker and Redeemer, grant us with all the faithful departed the sure benefits of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day, when you gather up all things in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of your promises. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anoint my head before oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord
praise and glory and honour when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy. For you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. This is the word of the Lord.
Blessed are those who die, Lord, for they rest from their labour.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me, I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life. And I will raise them up on the last day. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Please be seated.
The response is, when I say, here it is, the Lord, the response is our resurrection and our life. We'll have an intercessions in 1 minute. 10 minutes. Sorry.
It is as gentle as I am myself. Those are words that Gabriel Faure wrote to a friend about his setting of the Requiem Mass. We may not have known Faure and whether he lived up to the gentleness of the Requiem, but how could we disagree with him about his assessment of his own music? He went on, "My Requiem expresses not so much the fear of death as the peacefulness of eternal rest. For this is how I see death, as a happy deliverance, an aspiration to higher joys, not a joyless transition to some ominous unknown." This, I think, probably reflects the way most of us now think about death. And yet it is not at the same time the whole truth. The point of a Requiem Mass is to pray for the souls of those who have died, which would not be necessary if we knew precisely what had happened to them. I do think we can have quite a good idea, that our loved ones must surely have returned to the one who created them. And this is reflected in the readings we've just heard. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. Even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy. For you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. That goes from St. Peter to the living, beginning to receive salvation on this side of death. But then Jesus himself said in our gospel reading this evening, "This is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day." Now I could, of course, have chosen passages more about judgment, about the possibility that for some the afterlife is not so inevitably rosy. But I happen to find it hard that God has created anyone for damnation. And I do really believe that all who are created by God must surely somehow return to him. I believe this in my bones, and I find those passages that seem to imply otherwise very difficult, as I'm sure lots of us do. One argument against me and my view might be that it's rather arrogant of me. If someone doesn't believe in the God I do, how can I tell them that I think they might still go to heaven, a heaven they don't believe in? I do happen to believe that, on the whole, I think, but while I do, with all my being, I can't know that everyone is with God after this life. And I certainly can't know what heaven looks like. You might think my job as a priest is, in fact, to know, and to be sure, in fact, that no one has ever known precisely what lies on the other side of death. Confident as we may feel, as I do, that our loved ones are now with God. And so we pray for them. And that is, I believe, important. We prayed for them while they were alive, after all. And we pray for them now that they are gone. We pray that they are safe, that they are surrounded with God's love, and that we will join them when our own time comes. Our prayers for that, and indeed our confidence in what we pray for, are important. They are important, I believe, for our loved ones themselves and for God, but they are also important for us and for our sense of community with those we mourn with and with those who have left this life behind. Because whatever our uncertainty about what life after death looks like, one thing we as Christians are certain about is that we remain in community with those who have gone ahead of us. We are all part of the city of God together. And the primary way in which that community manifests itself is in prayer. When we pray, we do not pray alone, but with the whole community of heaven. We join with them whose whole state is prayer. All they do is prayer, day and night. Not that day or night exist where they are, but prayer is their constant state of being. And when we pray, we join with them in their prayer. When we sing, "Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts," as the choir will do for us later, or at least in Latin, "Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus, Dominus Deus Sabaoth," we join our voices with all the angels and saints, including those whom we have loved, but who are now safe with God. Now, those of you who are perhaps a little more sceptical may point out that we cannot know what the angels sing, that even if imagining them singing those words, that's surely just our human imagination. How do angels and those who died use words? What is the language of heaven? But sing they do somehow, and though we cannot imagine it visually, or the actual sound even, life after this one must be a life of prayer, and one we can join with. We may find it very hard to find words for that, particularly when in great grief. And this is where I think only silence or music can find the right language. And music does, after all, depend on silence, doesn't it? How would music work if it weren't for the rests? For the silence which peppers it and undergirds it, gives it its structure. I remember some years ago now, before I was ordained, quite a long time before, going to Westminster Abbey for All Souls, where they too were singing Faure's Requiem. And many years before that, a school friend of mine had died, and he died by his own hands. At that time, it had shocked me, obviously, but I hadn't been able to deal with it when it happened. And yet the music that evening, years later in the Abbey, opened up all my grief unexpectedly. And at the end of Mass that evening, I just wailed. It's rather embarrassing, really, but a kindly priest put me in a side chapel of the Abbey and he locked the door. And there I remained crying until everyone had gone home and the lights were turned out. And I stayed in that chapel crying, praying, though the bells were ringing out half muffled for a former dean, Michael Main, who had recently died. But do you know what the Requiem Mass that evening did for me, what the Faure in particular did for me, and why it caused me to have this sudden outpouring of grief? I think it was actually the gentleness of the Faure, as Faure himself described it, the simplicity and the compassion, which ends not with the Liberame as Verdi's does, crying for deliverance from judgment, but with the In Paradisum that we'll hear as we process out, talking instead of being received by the choirs of angels into heaven. The compassion of that music laid me bare that evening, and has allowed me to grieve for the first time, to feel loved by God, just as I really knew for the first time, I think, that Danny was loved by God as well. I still pray for him, as we will do alongside the many others whom we will remember in prayer this evening. But I also know deep in my bones that he is safe with his Maker. Amen.
Could you remain seated or kneel for the intercessions? The response is our resurrection and our life. When I say, hear us, Lord, our resurrection and our life. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
Let us pray to the Lord who has conquered death. Jesus, bread from heaven, you satisfy the hungry with good things. Grant us a share with all the faithful departed in the banquets of your kingdom. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
Jesus, the light of the world, you gave the man who was blind the gift of sight. Open the eyes of faith and bring us from darkness to your eternal life and glory. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
Jesus, Son of the living God, you summoned your friend Lazarus from death to life. Raise us at the last to full and eternal life with you. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
Jesus, crucified Saviour, in your dying you entrusted each to the other. Mary, your mother, and John, your beloved disciple, sustain and comfort all who mourn. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
Jesus, our way, the truth, and life. You drew your disciple Thomas from doubt to faith. Reveal the resurrection of faith to the doubting and to the lost. Hear us, risen Lord.
Our resurrection and our life.
And we now name all of those for whom we pray this evening. Bob Beadle. Tom Moore, Martha Moore, Olivia Wilson, Bill Wilson, Tilly Seward, J. Jim Cook, Susan Woolley, Frieda Sabine, Iris Maine Cox, John Benstead, Ronald Ernest Humphrey, Everton Anthony Jr. Bibby, Renee Dorothy Farley, Joseph Norman Stanbury, Uncle Roy, Ronald Victor Graves, Peggy Baxter, Roy Firth, Richard Tookie, Ernest Lawson, Lillian Lawson, Gillian Taylor, John Taylor, Muriel Lewin, Bob Fries, Bill Scott Priest,
Margaret Rogers, Paul Jenkins, Joseph DeMichael Priest, Charlotte Sharma, Daphne McFair, Charles and Frieda Stevenson, Hugh McAleer, Gladys Austin, Dennis Rochefort, Marlette D'Souza, Dorothy Larder, Joseph Larder, Gordon Larder, Randy Chambers, Faye Beadle, Albert Blackwood, Ivy Wild, Vic Hall, Howard Copeland, Grace Holday, Valerie Miller, Maud Miller, Sheila Baines, Maurice Baines,
Ina Avery, Len Miller, Violet Brick, William Foster, Captain J.S. Codgy, Anthony O'Burrough, Olufemi Ogundeji, Major Rubin J. Codgy, Sue Akinsanya, William Thorne, Margaret Thorne, Coletta Hordy, James Harding, Claudette Jackson, Delroy Jackson, Balfour Jackson, Reuben Menzie, George Williamson, Winifred Presley, Gabriel Coffey, Peter Swan, Buster Silvera, Askew Silvera, Sybil Hines.
Amos Odieka, Adwick Davis, Henshaw Atook, Ackman Davis, Samson Davies, Lindsay Charles Hall, Mary Craigan, Maureen Craigan, Shirley Craigan, Mike Craigan, Charles Craigan, Roy Percival, Catherine Kinchin, Joyce, Peggy Judge, Bill Judge, Catherine Heatley, Kathleen Bridgman, Rixford Bridgman, Bonnie Jones, Doris Riquez, Joanne Bailey, Raymond Thurston Clark, Hannah Louise Clark, Dennis Mansfield Ratcliffe, Molly Ratcliffe, Reverend Charisoma Rahindi,
Joan and Ken Coombs, Molly and Gordon Breen, Grace and Albert Betts, Alan Betts, Betty and David Walden, Peter Walden, Barbara Moore, Gladys and Philip White, Janice Garrett, Mary and Peter Short, Evelyn Coombs, Michael Alderton, Ethel and Jim Brown, Mary and Peter Short, Angelina, Valerie, Joy, Sanjay, Angela Carroll, Koloole Onamade, Mr. Gurrell, Peggy Joyce Hawkins, Danny Blore.
Marilyn Brent Ryan, Vincent Campbell, Harold Bomini, Jean Earle, Jermaine Miller, Judy Stacey, Rudy Singh, Rosalie Davis, Austin Aubrey, Tom Grandmayer, Harry Engler, Peter John Engler, Judy Gray, Eleanor Husbands, Liebert Husbands, Ira Husbands, Hansley Husbands, Rose Jackson, Cynthia Walters, Esther Holder, Seymour Holder,
lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming. Enfold them in the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and in the glorious company of the saints in light. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord. We rejoice that we never pray alone, but supported by a great cloud of witnesses, holy people of every time and place. And we ask Mary, Queen of the Saints and Mother of the Redeemed, to join her prayers with ours, and those of all the whole company of heaven, as we say, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Just a word before we move into the liturgy of the sacrament to say that if you're used to receiving communion in your home church, if you're visiting, you're very welcome to receive here. If you prefer to come up for a blessing at that point, please bring your order of service with you so that I know to give you a blessing. And wait for the wardens to invite you to come up and then to direct you back to your seats.
Thank you.
up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth, giver of life and conqueror of death. By his death on the cross, your Son, Jesus Christ, offered the one true sacrifice for sin, breaking the power of evil and putting death to flight. Through his resurrection from the dead, you have given us new birth into a living hope, into an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading. The joy of resurrection fills the universe, and so we join with angels and archangels, with all your faithful people, evermore praising you and saying, same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Praise to you, Lord Jesus, dying you destroyed our death, rising you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, St. John Baptist, the blessed apostles and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Remember your servants whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Uniting our prayers with the whole company of heaven, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus is the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, they will live forever. Lord, give us this bread of ours. I am the bread of life, says the Lord. Whoever comes to me will never hunger. Whoever believes in me will never thirst. I am the vine, you are the branches. May we dwell in him as he lives in us. Thank you. Please stand. Gracious God, we thank you that in your great love you have fed us with the food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but fullness of joy with all your saints. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy, in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Neither death nor life can separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.